Even while the country is gearing up for a general election, there are still persistent concerns about military intervention. Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha himself recently had to brush off journalists' question about the possibility of a coup d'etat.
Well, I think the classic domination of military forces directly intervening into Thai politics, ruling the country, wearing uniforms, and serving at the same time as military chiefs. Those days are almost gone, limited. Only maybe extremely special circumstances that are going to be more difficult in this new normal. Simply on one factor, forces to allow the military chief to do that are not under the chief's direct control anymore, especially in Bangkok.
You mean the structure of the armed forces is much different from the past?
Exactly, exactly. That's one. But more importantly, of course, the popular sentiment inside Thailand and outside of the country is so different. You cannot turn back the clock, and examples are everywhere. On borders, you see the attempt to turn back the clock, and that's ended up in disaster. That's number two.
Yeah.
But number three, and maybe this is the defining answer, the military is already, you know, contesting in elections. They have elaborated, you know, structures that support some of their interests, especially in the Senate. So some of my academic friends say, well, that's another kind of military intervention by itself.
but the public democratically done, right?
But publicly accepted by the referendum for the time being. And this is not also quite different from when you see the South Korean military forces, you know, gradually, you know, stepping down and then entering politics. The Indonesian military forces gradually stepping down, and years ago, before that, forces in Latin American countries, the same. They gradually designing, you know, the political system when they are, when they were in full power, to allow them to return for the contestation, for the popular support, and they became leaders of different countries. And this is already happening in Thailand. So when you add these three factors, the possibility of the classic, the real military intervention in the old ways, maybe almost gone or gone. But then again, no one can say for sure. This is happening last time when people said there's no coup. I would say in a new normal, unless there's a big breakdown in terms of a confrontation between the elite, between the masses, between the middle class, and there is a chaotic situation, and the security, domestic security is out of control, then maybe the military may step in. But that worst case scenario.
Thailand's two top leaders and once comrades in arms, General Prayut Chan-o-cha and General Pravit Wongsuwan, are going their separate ways in the upcoming election to try to become the next prime minister if they are rejected at the polls. Will they be willing to quietly walk away and let politicians run the country?
It depends on two or three factors. But of course, the ultimate indicator will be support to any single political party. If you win decisively and are able to form one ruling party government elected, I think there's no doubt. I think it's going to be difficult. But of course, it did happen in our neighbor that that didn't go well with the military. But in Thailand, I think the situation may be different. But that possibility is also may not be the highest. The second maybe the highest possibility is a coalition government. And then then shared powers is a successful formula. The way out, meaning that the military may have some elected representatives and other populist parties maybe get elected. And through the negotiation, it's going to be tough to negotiate too. Depending on how many MPs you win on both party lists, 100 or 500 in the parliament. And then negotiation, once it's done, like in many countries in Europe, then you can see, you can form a coalition government. And I think the culture of coalition government across the old ideologies are now more possible. Now possible. The confrontation between the red shirts and the yellow shirts are almost gone. Only emerging a new interesting challenges between young generation wanting Thailand to go much more progressive. And then maybe the older generation who concerns about continuity, certainty. That requires a compromise through this election and the after election negotiation. The composition of the coalition government will tell you how successful this negotiation will be, because as expected from the polls, no one expected to win decisively. But again, the polls were wrong last time.